been rather busy lately. Asking questions, investigating. So is that it? You're some kind of investigator? A detective for hire? Or do you have some kind of personal grudge against an innocent android who simply wants to be left alone? Please, tell me. I'd really like to know. Well, if that's true, then the first thing you need to do is halt your investigation. No more questions. No more searching. The movement I'm involved with, we help his kind escape their Commonwealth-imposed slavery. We help them disappear. You understand? You really want help? Take this. It's an internal component from the very android you're searching for. Don't ask how I obtained it. Present it to Dr. Zimmer in Rivet City. Tell him the android is dead and that was on the corpse. He'll believe you. Do that and Zimmer will go back to the Commonwealth and leave that poor soul alone. Do that and you'll have saved a man's life. Just understand that this android is now, for all intents and purposes, a man. He looks human, he acts human, he believes he is human. But even if he's not, even if he's a machine, he's capable of rational thought and emotion. So you see, his soul is as human as yours or mine. This person, and he is a person, deserves a chance at freedom. Please, if there's a shred of decency in you, don't take that away from him. You know what you need to do.
How the hell did you get in here? I suppose you can't be all that bad if you made it this far without dying. This is the part where you tell me what the hell you are doing bothering an old man who obviously wants to be left alone. Get on with it already. I live here. It's where I do my work, and it's far away from Dr. Lee and all those other monkeys dressed up like scientists. You made it past my defenses, which proves you aren't a dummy. And you haven't killed me, so I suppose you aren't here to do that. I suppose you can hang around if you want. Just don't touch anything. The secret kind. Well, if you must know, I'm an electrician and computer expert. and I'm a bit of a surgeon. Really, the most gifted scientist you'll find. And the guy that got Rivet City up and running in the first place. And after all that, Lee and her gang of flunkies pushed me out. Project Purity, indeed. But a bunch of morons. They can't even clean some water. What? I have better things to do than yak about those backstabbers up topside. Now get going. I know lots of things, but you've got no idea about most of them. Now get going before I stop talking and start shooting. Don't let your guard down.
Are you okay?
Let me or a security officer know if you see anything out.
Don't you have a component to deliver?
Everything looks okay here.
Welcome to Rivet City Supply. I've got a little bit of everything here.
Nice to see you.
Howdy, I'm Seagrave. Seagrave Holmes. I have a little of just about everything here. I've got a little bit of everything. Yep, old Pinkerton. They say he helped found Rivet City. Must be some sort of crazy genius. He kind of vanished a long time ago. I don't know where he went, but you might ask around the ship. See you later.
Stay sharp. They're everywhere.
What are you talking about, boy? I don't know anything about any of that. And what did you call it? An android?
What's that? Fine, whatever. This android calls himself Harkness now. Comes in and wants a memory job. I took new memories and replaced his old ones. Don't believe anyone's done that before. Certainly not down here. That Commonwealth tech isn't all that fancy when it comes down to it. I'm also the only one in the wasteland with the skill and the nerve to perform facial surgery. That android flesh ain't so different than ours. You want proof? I documented the whole thing, so I could rub it in the face of Dr. Lee when I need to rankle her feathers. I hate that snooty bitch. That witch ruined my life, but you're right. Who gives a crap about any of that? You want your precious proof. It's all in my computer. Here's the password. See for yourself. Hell, just take these pictures and this holotape. Straight from the synth man's lips. Just don't go telling Harkness, though. He won't believe you anyway. And you really don't want to see him upset. He can be a bit inhospitable. Maybe I am. Maybe I'm going to have my android army rise up against you and your human ilk. Sorry. Oh, sorry I couldn't resist. I suppose you're right. But don't worry, I didn't really wipe his memories. I just buried them. But you can get them back. All you need to do is use the recall code. Just say to him, activate A321 recall code Violet, and that will activate the hidden subroutines. Don't let your guard down.
Thank you.
I'm a little busy right now. Is there a problem? What's that supposed to mean? Look, kid, I don't have time for existential debate, and I'm not interested in whatever religion you're peddling. Excuse me? Look, kid, you have exactly 5 seconds to explain what you're trying to do here, or you'll be leaving Rivet City by the way of the nearest porthole. Truth. If there's one thing I've learned, it's this. There is no such thing as the truth, just the appearance of truth. And for anyone to try to sell their version of the truth, they need evidence. You have no evidence for your ridiculous claims, so I have no more time to waste talking with you. All right, I'll humor you. But this is impossible. I can't be a robot, I'm a human being. I breathe, I eat. Hell, I cut myself shaving this morning. I was bleeding. Robots don't bleed. I'm not sure what to say. I'm not sure what to even think about all this. I'll admit, this is pretty convincing evidence, but it doesn't make any sense. How can this be possible? Ah! My God. I remember. I remember it all from before. Zimmer, the Commonwealth, the Institute. My God, all those runners I brought down. You made me remember. Why? How? Never mind. My God, what am I going to do? My life, everything, it's all a lie. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to shove him into a very small box and send him north where he belongs. He is a security threat, isn't he? All right. I authorize you to carry out Dr. Zimmer's execution. Don't think this gives you license to run around shooting anyone you want. Just Zimmer. And that bodyguard, if he gets in the way. Here, use my weapon. I've had it forever, and it's never let me down. Consider it a token of my appreciation. Carry on, then. So, dude, did that key ever get you anything?
Don't you have a component to deliver? I'll be right with you.
The ship's water isn't much better. If we don't get fresh water soon, we'll all...
Leave me alone! This is not a...
Hey there.
The sooner you find my property, the sooner I can get out of this slum. Really, how do you people live like this? Harkness, you say? Yes, that makes sense. He used to work for a special branch of the Commonwealth Police, after all. And he's right here, in Rivet City? Excellent. I must wait, find an opportune moment to confront him. Thank you for your discreet assistance and continued discretion regarding this matter. And now for your payment. This combat module will directly affect your central nervous system. I think you will find it quite beneficial.
Hmm.
you?
Yes. Hey there. Sounded like pure fantasy, even for someone of Braun's capabilities.
It was nothing short of a miracle. A terraforming module capable of producing life from complete lifelessness. Not only was it distributed to several vaults to be used after an atomic war. Vault 101 was, sadly, not on that list. I did some digging and discovered Braun's name on the reservation list for a vault. But this man, he could have easily succeeded where I failed. Does his collected knowledge remain within the halls of Vault 112? Journals, holotapes, computer records, maybe even experiments. If I could gain access to just a fraction of Braun's genius, Project Purity would become a reality. Even in Vault 101, my work on Project Purity was successful. Soon after
he
arrived, sneaking into the restricted areas, searching for, I don't know, whatever I could find. It was a Vault-type facility, after all. Advanced technology this country had ever developed. Those excursions never turned up anything particularly useful. So, one night, after half a bottle of scotch, I broke into the overseer's office. It was easy enough to hack his console, gain access to the restricted files. Most of it was garbage. Propaganda, spy reports, just plain rambling bullshit, really. But there was one thing, one name that stood out amongst all the others. Dr. Stanislaus Braun. I knew of Braun's work, of course. He was a celebrity in his day. Voltex sorcerer scientist, leaving his peers in awe of his technological wizardry. But it was in Vault 101 that night in the overseer's office. I first learned of Braun's involvement in Voltex social preservation program and his work on something called GEC, the Garden of Eden Creation Kit. I'm off to Vault 112 to search for anything of Braun's that might help me get this purifier up and running. All I know is that it's west of some place called Evergreen Mills, and it's well hidden in some sort of garage. But I'll find it. I have to. It's so close, but that's the story of Project Purity, isn't it? An eternity of almost theirs. Let's see if Braun has the missing puzzle piece.
Welcome to Vault 112, resident. According to sensors, you have arrived 202.3 years behind schedule. Please redress in your Vault Tech issued Vault suit before proceeding. If you have misplaced your suit, I am authorized to distribute a new one. Once dressed, please proceed down the stairs to the main floor so that you may enter your assigned Tranquility Lounger. Please take a seat in the nearest available Tranquility Lounger. Thank you for your cooperation.
Hello.
Hey there, sport. Beautiful day, isn't it? Say, you should go talk to Betty. She's waiting for you over on the playground. Have fun, sport.
Oh, someone new to play with. What good luck I have lately. I was just starting to get bored. Oh, we're going to have so much fun.
I'm Betty. I live here on Tranquility Lane. Want to play a game? I knew you would. It's a really simple game. All you have to do is make Timmy Newsbum cry. You can? I guess we'll see. Huh. Good luck.
Son, you've saved me. I was afraid I'd be trapped in there forever. It's so good to see you, but what are you doing here? Well, I'm glad you did. I was right about Braun. But take note. Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Try not to kill him.
Some news.
The question that's been raised, I know, has to do with. It's been 2 weeks since
the well, look who's back. Are they all dead yet? Did you bring me any proof? Wasn't the plan. I suppose I have to pay for the key anyway, though. Here.
The waters of life. Free and clean. For any and all.
It's pretty far away. Northwest of here. Getting there won't do you any good, though. Not without those keys. Good riddance. The wasteland is better off without him. I thought I told you to kill him. That rat bastard is still alive. I'll pay for the key, but you really screwed up.
The caravans are coming.
I'll pay you for the key, but I'm very disappointed.
This round's on me.
Well, they may not all be dead, but I have the keys. I should have hired a better mercenary. Run along. I have a trick to plan.
Thank you.
Vault 1. Please find... find the nearest Tranquility Lounger and be seated.
Hello.
Son, you've saved me. I was afraid I'd be trapped in there forever. It's so good to see you, but what are you doing here? Well, I'm glad you did. This certainly wasn't how I expected things to turn out. I wasn't ready for Brawn, or I might have fared better. It certainly is. It's nice to feel that I'm on two legs again. And thanks to Dr. Brawn, I know that Project Purity isn't lost after all. I was right about Brawn. The technology he developed is unstable, even dangerous. But it can be adapted for Project Purity. I need to return to Rivet City and talk with Madison. If we can find a Geck, we can make Project Purity work. Yes, with what I've learned, Madison is sure to see that we can finally succeed where we failed so many years ago. I'd like you to come with me. I'd like you to be there when we finally open the floodgates. That's my boy. Let's hurry. Now that I know what we need, I want to get back to work as soon as possible. Be careful, my son.
Hello, sir.
I told you it would work, Madison, and now I can prove it.
James, you're back.
And with good news. I was right about Brawn and the Geck. If we can find one, we can adapt it to work with the purifiers.
I'd like to believe you, James. I really would. This is all just so... so sudden.
Madison, I'm telling you, this is real. I talked to Braun himself. He confirmed it. Don't you see? This is what we've been waiting for.
I don't know, James. So many years have passed. Is it really still worth trying?
How could it not be worth improving the lives of everyone in the Wasteland? What could be a more worthy endeavor?
You haven't lost any of your passion, have you, James?
It's as important to me as ever, Madison. I know it's important to you, too. Let's finish it together.
James, we don't have a Geck. I can get a small team together, but we'll need proof that it works before people believe us.
I know. I was thinking about that. The lab at the facility had some old pre-war computers that we scavenged. One of them might be useful.
From the last reports, there's no power at the facility. Even if one of those computers had a database, we couldn't access it.
That's why we're going to head over there right now and get things up and running as best we can.
You know, if it were anyone else asking me to do this, I'd have them run right out of Rivet City.
And you know I wouldn't be here if I didn't think this would really work. It's time, Madison.
Damn you, James. When this is all over, you owe me a drink. I'll get the team together.
Thank you, Madison. It's good to be working with you again.
Don't touch the vegetables. They're fragile.
We need to get back to Project Purity. The computer there is our best chance to locate a Geck. That's my boy. It'll be good to work side by side with you, son.
Yes?
Is everything all right?
Cindy will kill me if I'm late again.
Is everything all right?
Did you need something?
We can't accomplish anything until we can get inside. But none of us are particularly capable fighters. I hate to ask you to put yourself in harm's way, but you seem to have learned to handle yourself. I need you to go in and make sure it's safe for Dr. Lee and her crew. Be careful. Thank you. some. Are you all right? Is it safe in there? I'm proud of you. Now let's get in there. I understand that you have reason to question a good many things I've told you over the years. But your mother... I've never lied to you about what happened. Not once. She died giving birth to you. It was a difficult time. She was so eager to meet you, to make a place for you in the world. If nothing else, please believe that she loved you very much. Be careful, my son.
Yes? Hey there.
Yes?
Hey, did you need something?
Here we are, where it all began. You remember your mother's favorite passage? Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. Don't you see? This is what it all means. The water, the purifier. This is the water of life. Your mother's dream. No point in wasting time. Let's get to work. There's much to be done. The project was abandoned shortly after you were born. Things have deteriorated here since then, and there's been some flooding. I need you to get to the flood control pumps and activate them so we can clear out the water and reach the mainframe. The automatic doors sealed when the flooding occurred, so you'll have to use the access tunnels to reach the pumps.
What? How's it going?
How are you holding up? Need directions? You're in the security level. It's full of holding tanks for the water, as well as our processing equipment and power systems. I'll see you when you get back. Great work on the pumps. Hurry back, and I'll give you the fuse. I've been hearing good things about you. Is it true? Did you really disarm the bomb in Megaton? I'm very proud of you, even though you put yourself in harm's way. Just please be careful out there. This is a dangerous world, far more dangerous than anyone in that vault knows. Right. The flooding shorted out some of the fuse boxes downstairs, including one that controls some of the automatic doors. Here, take these fuses. The box is back down on the sub-basement near the eastern end of the level. Once the fuses are replaced, you'll be able to get to the mainframe. Be careful, my son. fuse is in place, you should be able to access the mainframe. No need to come back to the control room. Just head straight there. A few minor repairs still to be made up here in the control room. Why don't you come back here and give me a hand? Actually, wait. There's one other thing I need you to do. Jana says there's a blockage in one of the intake pipes. It's on your way back. Head back up to the museum level and give me a call on the intercom when you get there. I'll see you when you get back.
Hello.
Just outside the pipe that's been giving us trouble. Now don't worry, this isn't dangerous at all. Just get inside and use the manual controls to drain the pipe. That'll break up the debris enough for the filters to function properly. Now I won't be able to contact you once you're in there. You'll exit near the systems, and then you can get in touch with me again.
Facility is now under United States government control. The person in charge is to step forward immediately and turn over all materials related to this project.
That's quite impossible. This is a private project. The Enclave has no authority here. I'm going to have to ask you to leave at once.
Am I to assume, sir, that you are in charge?
Yes, I'm responsible for this project.
Then I repeat, sir, that you are hereby instructed to immediately hand over all materials related to the purifier.
I'm sorry, but that's...
Furthermore, you are to assist Enclave scientists in assuming control of the administration and operation of this facility at once.
Colonel, is it Colonel? I'm sorry, but the facility is not operational. It never has been. I'm afraid you're wasting your time here.
Sir, this is the last time I am going to repeat myself. Stand down at once and turn over control of this facility.
Colonel, I assure you that this facility will not function. We have never been able to successfully replicate test results.
I suggest you comply immediately, sir, in order to prevent any more incidents. Are we clear?
Yes, Colonel. I'll do whatever you want. There's no need for more violence.
Then you will immediately hand over all materials related to this project and aid us in making it operational at once.
Very well. Give me a few moments to bring the system online.
Enough of these delays.
Almost ready. I'm compiling the data now. Run. Run!
James. He's gone. We have to get out of here. They'll be coming for us next. We've got to evacuate now. James, your father caused an overload. He sacrificed himself to keep the Enclave from getting the purifier and to buy us some time to escape. There'll be more of them coming. We need to get out of here before they find us, or else your father died in vain. There's an old tunnel that will lead us out of here to someplace safe. We used it as an evacuation route once before, but that was a long time ago. I hope everyone remembers how to get there. There isn't time to round everyone up. Come on, follow me, and hurry! We need to escape while we can. Don't wander off. We're going to need you. This tunnel leads to the Citadel, the Brotherhood of Steel's Fortress. We should be safe there, if we can make it. We need to keep everyone together, and we need to get through this tunnel as quickly as possible. We're not safe until we reach the other side. You should stay close, and we'll follow behind you. We'll be right behind you. Be careful.
Good to see you.
Not at liberty to discuss the details of the election. You understand? But rest assured, I am your president. Because the appropriate people of this great nation decided I should be. I am your duly elected representative. Of course, when the time comes, when my turn is up.
There's a locked door up ahead. I can open it, but it'll take some time.
Now and forever. Now, dearest America, we must say, there is much work to do.
Oh!
this nation's youth are truly happy, truly carefree. Well, we both know the answer, don't we?
We need to escape while we can.
Every youth program, an
Madison Lee. I have people with me in need of shelter. You must allow us access at once.
I'm sorry, ma'am. No unauthorized civilians allowed inside the Citadel. You'll have to leave now.
Lyons! I know you're in there! I know you can hear me! You open this goddamn door right now!
Need something, friend?
Madison, I'm surprised to see you here. What can I do for you?
Don't talk down to me, Lyons. I had nowhere else to turn. You must help us. Project Purity has been overrun.
Yes, I'd heard reports of an incident there. What details can you give us?
The Enclave. They've attacked Project Purity. James is dead. There may be more. I don't know. You have to do something.
Then it's as we feared. Madison, I'm sorry this happened. I wish we could have done something.
Then do something now. They've taken over the purifier. Lyons, they cannot be permitted to have control over it. It's not right.
No. Calm down. You know as well as I do that the purifier doesn't work. It's useless to them. Perhaps it's time to walk away.
That's not true. James, he found what's been missing. We know how to get it running.
Is that so? Does the Enclave know this?
No, I don't think... I don't know. I just don't know what's happening anymore.
All right, Madison, it'll be okay. Now, this is James's son, I presume? I can see the resemblance.
Yes. He knows what we need. Vault-Tec computer, something to locate equipment. Please help him.
Very well. We'll sort this all out.
I need to rest, lie down or something. This is just too much. Rothschild should help you, but don't forget that he's Brotherhood. I've never trusted them. Be careful what you tell them.
What was the result of the latest scan?
Enclave troops have fortified the purifier complex, with those vertebirds they're able to transport personnel at a remarkable rate.
I see.
You honor us.
You have my condolences. Your father was a good man. More than anyone else, I dare say. Certainly enough to know they're the greatest threat the Capital Wasteland has ever faced. The Brotherhood of Steel has encountered the Enclave before, you see. Over 30 years ago, back in California. Then they were led by a President Richardson. Now we've got this Eden to contend with. It matters not now, as before, they seek to control and destroy, all in the guise of restoring order. Your father, I fear, was just the beginning. The Brotherhood is an old organization going back to the years just after the war. We are but a part of it. What would you like to know? The Brotherhood began on the West Coast and exists there still. We were dispatched to this location many years ago. In truth, the Brotherhood of Steel has been struggling for years, both here and back home. Honor, truth, courage. These virtues seem to have little meaning in these troubled times, I'm afraid. So be it. Of course.
With your presence here.
You just managed to get yourself into all sorts of trouble, don't you? Welcome to the Citadel. Not many civilians get to see the place. I've read the reports, seen the initial scans, but I can hardly believe it. I figured those radio transmissions were just old recordings. Never figured the Enclave would actually show up in the flesh. But don't worry. Whatever they try, we'll be ready for it. I'll lead the Pride to knock them out tomorrow, if my father permits it. In my father's name, I bid you farewell. Yeah.
Yeah.
May I start by saying that I am sorry for your loss. I was acquainted with your father many years ago. The world has lost one of its few remaining visionaries. Think nothing of it. Now, Dr. Lee has explained your predicament. You need to locate some Vault-Tec equipment. A Geck? Goodness no, certainly not. I must say that there are some who doubt such a device really exists, let alone works. If, however, you share your father's determination, I may be able to assist you in locating one. Possibly. I'm afraid I won't be able to assist you directly. The news Dr. Lee has brought will require me to be elsewhere. I can, however, give you access to an old pre-war computer from Vault-Tec. It may have the information you need.
You'll find the terminal in the archives in the A-ring.
You are welcome. If you require further assistance, I may be able to help.
Hail.
The Brotherhood... ...that is at your service.
Need something, Frank?
You honor us.
Did you have any success with that old terminal?
Ah,
well, that much I believe I can help with. Step over here for a moment. I'll show you where it is.
With your presence here.
This map shows the locations of all known vaults in the local area. Vault 87 has been highlighted for you. There. Entrance to Vault 87 will be particularly difficult for you, I'm afraid. The area is highly irradiated. Lethal levels are all around the entrance. Gaining direct access will be quite impossible. You share your father's determination, it seems. And in this case, you are correct. There may well be another way. Vault 87 is located very close to the site of Lamplight Caverns. It is entirely probable that the vault may be entered from within the caves. The Brotherhood simply cannot spare the resources necessary to investigate the area. Perhaps you may be more successful. If you do find anything, please return here so that we may decide how best to proceed. I wish we could do more, but the Brotherhood potentially faces a very pressing, very real threat in the Enclave. All of my efforts must now be devoted to assessing the threat they may pose to us. I'm sure you understand.
Hail to you, son of James! What more did you want to know? It's been over 20 years since we arrived, and we've been struggling to contain and eradicate the super mutants for nearly as long. With the arrival of the Enclave, I have a terrible feeling the super mutants are the least of our worries. So be it. steel be with you.
There's a problem in the cooling system. I'm not sure what it is, but I'll take a look.
The Brotherhood is at your service.
Quartermaster Durga here, stranger. I have to say, I'm not sure what you're doing in my armory. We run a tight ship, and unless Elder Lion says so, we don't trade with outsiders. Quartermaster out.
Yes? This is not normally something that we do. Trade with outsiders has proven to be problematic in the past. However, considering the circumstances, so be it. I'll send word to Durga that you have full access to trade. Of course.
I received word from Elder Lyons. He says that you have permission to trade with us. Good for you. I should let you know, I'm not going to use any of our equipment to provide parts for you. You'll have to pay for them. Yeah, I suppose. Thanks. Steel be with you.